Back here in the Mid-South, we should learn tomorrow who will fill the seat of former Memphis City Councilmember Phillip Spinoza, who recently resigned to join the Chamber of Commerce.
Spinoza represented Super District 9, along with Councilman Kemp. Conrad Berlin Boyd represents District 7. Good to have you both.
Good morning.
Thank you for having us.
Morning.
So you've got a list to choose for. What will you be looking for particularly? Let's start with you, Kemp, since it is also your district that you share with the person taking over Spinoza's seat.
Yeah, I think it's a lot of different factors. One, I think someone that's going to be a good fit. We have a really good council right now. We have a good mayor, a great administration.
Everybody works together.
Everybody's working very well together. I think we're getting a lot done for Memphis and for Memphians. So someone that's going to fit in is important. I think someone that served the community before, someone that, you know, understands the community and, you know, has those relationships. Not someone, you know, not to have had political service, but someone that's been involved and been in some kind of service role. And then someone who will be a quick study and get up to speed on what's a $700 million business at the end of the day.
Yeah.
And be able to step in and add value. So those are some of the main criteria that I'll be looking for.
Berlin Boyd, what would you like to see?
I think going down the same lines, I think it's important for someone to be able to step in right in the middle of budget. So they're going to have to make some big decisions very quickly. But someone that actually can mix and mingle with the existing council, I think is very important. You know, being a person that served two interim terms, I know the difficulties and the learning curves that you will face.
Right. Yeah, you mentioned the budget just a second ago. Let's transition into that. Where do we stand with it right now? Have you gotten any additional feedback from the fire unions, the police unions about where they stand as far as pay raises? What's the latest there?
Well, we're in the process right now of going through the council. We've been meeting for the last couple weeks every night to discuss our budget. We're going through our operations budget, and we've already gone through CIP. Of course, we've heard from unions and every other union within the city of Memphis. They definitely want raises. And we've put together our impasse committees, which are made up of three individual council members that's randomly picked. One is picked by the administration, the other one's picked by the union, and then those two members pick a third member. They have come back with their decisions as it pertains to if they're going to go with the unions or if they're going with the administration. So we will deal with that as well tomorrow at council.
So let's start with what you like particularly, if there's one thing that you think the budget's particularly strong in, and one area where you'd like to see a little bit of improvement. Kemp, start with you.
You know, I'm going to wait. I mean, I think it's a good budget, and you know, I think we're trying to find the right balance. If we've got about $10 million additional dollars in revenue this year, you know, which is good. So I think the real debate is how do we best spend those dollars? We have a lot of needs, and then even going forward, we have more of the pension arc that we have to do and some more obligations. We're losing the Hall income tax on investment incomes.
So how much money do you expect that will be?
I think that's like $15 million annually once it fully ramps up.
Right.
So it'd be great to be able to give raises, you know, every year, but sometimes that's not feasible. We've had last couple of years, we've had some pretty significant raises for folks, and so, you know, we're just trying to find the balance. There are a lot of needs in the city.
Mm-hmm.
Berlin, are there areas that stick out to you that
I just think like Kemp just said, it's one of those things you're trying to find a balance. It's all about, for me, driving more dollars to constituent services, and I think that's important. I think we want to see our city clean. We want to see our city have more services for youth. The mayor's done a good job of putting money in the budget for youth services. But I think that we got to get back to making sure our community centers, libraries, parks are safe, clean, cut. And that's what the majority of Memphians want. They also want their streets paved.
Yeah,
and
what does Mayor Strickland always say? It's potholes, crime. It's the things that impact ordinary
citizens.
It's
those basic things.
Where do we stand also on the issue of the Civilian Review Board? We've heard some members in the past couple of weeks saying they don't feel they're really getting the respect from the top brass at police. Are people really listening to their position when it comes to police matters? Where do we stand on that issue with them?
Well, the issue was brought up to me last week as it pertains to the difficulties that the CLERB is having with the recommendations that they make to MPD. This year was the first year that we changed from Councilman Morgan as the liaison. We changed to Councilman Spinoza. So the new replacement person will become the liaison for CLRB as well.
And is that wise? Because after all, you mentioned you're in budget season. That's already a very big hill to climb. I mean, can you make a different decision and say, you know what, you're new, we're going to give this to someone else, or is that
I think we're leaning towards replacing with the vice chair of public police and public safety, and that's Councilwoman Swearingen. We may just let her move into the role, but you know, those are Phillip's existing committees.
Right.
But you know, I think it's one of those things where a CLRB is a recommendation body to MPD, and all recommendations MPD may find their investigations a little different than what the board recommends.
Kemp, how do you see this as well when it comes to CLRB?
I think very highly of Director Rollins and the command staff at MPD. And at the end of the day, I think this is a role of city government on how we discipline police officers, and I fully trust Director Rollins and his team.
So should we disband CLRB?
I wasn't for CLRB. I trust Director Rollins and his team. I think they do a really good job. I think they're very transparent. I think now that we have body cams, that's done a lot in terms of keeps our officers more safe when someone knows they're getting filmed, and then the officers know that they're being filmed as well. So I think that you know, that's done a lot in terms of complaints on police officers. And again, I trust Director Rollins and his command staff.
Would you go so far as to say we should disband CLRB?
Well, I think it involves and it allows the community to have a role in it. But I think if those members of that body don't get results that they expect, then that's something that, you know, you have to expect the command staff will handle.
All